A new round of Star Wars movies have come out where Ewoks have eyelids. And people poo-poo George Lucas for all his adventures in CGI. But I want to make a case, you guys, for Jar Jar Binks being the single greatest creation in all of modern storytelling. Boo all you want, nerds, but guess what? You're lazy. You're lazy for booing so quickly. Look, I know he's horrible to look at. He's a fucking CGI minstrel show, salamander Roger Rabbit, and you want to end your life watching him in this. It's fine. I understand. I agree. But he is still the single greatest creation in the history of modern storytelling, and I'll tell you why. The first movie, Jar Jar Binks, obviously garbage, but he's there for little kids. That was George Lucas's idea. This little kid is watching Jedis lop each other's heads off with swords. And go, oh, here's my friend, my weird, goofy friend I remember from before I was in danger. He will keep me safe. All of America told George Lucas, go fuck yourself. And George Lucas got crushed by his own genius. The second movie, Jar Jar's a senator. He's only in the movie for 2 seconds, so all the nerds kind of backed off. But something was going on. George Lucas's plan went bananas. The third movie, Jar Jar Binks is directly responsible for the legislation that enables Emperor Palpatine to commit intergalactic genocide, murder swaths of baby Jedis, enslave entire planets. Jar Jar Binks's character arc is retarded weird animal thing, Senator Mussolini. So before you piss on him, I want you to think for a second. Okay, when have you seen anything like that ever? A thing meant for little kids that suddenly murdered all of them. I want you, if anyone ever talks about it, I want you to keep up this vibe of George Lucas, you are doing a great job, because if we keep telling him he's doing okay, if we keep supporting him creatively, few decades. He's very old. He might put out a version of Return of the Jedi that will end with an elderly Jar Jar Binks in a war tribunal being held accountable for his crimes. Lusa does a very, very bad entrance. Oh, boy. Lots of dead young ones. Oh. Sorry. But Mon Mothma, Galactic Rebellion, I just want to say that before my sentence is carried out and the Rancor Beast mounts me from behind and injects my anal cavity with its eggs, and due to a Rancor Beast's 10-second gestational cycle, the eggs will burst forth from my anus as I am kicked out of an airlock into the vacuum of space, and as each molecule of my body freezes in a tiny infinity, I will be ripped to shreds by the tiny baby beasts. Before this happens, I just want to say, the trains in Naboo always ran on time.